Hello everybody and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. We did it! We beat the Deacons of the Deep. But no Aldrich to be found in the cathedral. And when he came back here right after the fight, first of all, I found some old friends whom I cannot wait to talk to because I'm kind of afraid they might leave at some point without me getting the chance to talk to them, so let's have a go at them. Yep. Same old, same old. Okay, what does Andrea have to say?
Oh, and we meet again.
We certainly do.
We spoke before on the road of sacrifices. Anri of Astora.
Mm-hmm.
I'm well pleased to see you safe.
I remember you.
We reached the Cathedral of the Deep, but Aldrich's coffin was empty.
Right.
The man-eater must have left for his true home. The little doll in the empty coffin told me. Aldrich is said to hail from Irithyll in the Boreal Valley, an ancient fabled city. A pilgrim told me that the city lies beyond Farron Keep, and so becomes our destination.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I thought, and that's where, remember when we beat the Abyss Watchers, after the bonfire opened, there was also this, the secret passage that opened up. I bet that leads to the Boreal Valley.
Aldrich's honest home is Irithyll in the Boreal Valley. Yeah. Pilgrim and so.
Okay, so actually, when I beat the Deacons of the Deep on a different character, the one you saw in the last episode, right after the almost at the end. If you watch that far. That is, I saw Horus there, his summon sign, but I also saw Anri's summon sign, which I just managed to, miss the one time before that when I tried the boss. I must have been embered up, but yeah.
Gaining admission to the Legion is a matter of some ceremony. Inside their keep,
yeah, we know all
snuffing
that.
Out the flames of three altars, even accursed undead want I pity.
Alright. I thought he would be giving us a ring at this point, somebody told me, because that's maybe something that's missable. Not quite sure. But let's go back to the Deacons of the Deep, because there's some more stuff that we've yet to do there. We're not done with that place yet. First of all, that's a pretty substantial coffin, if you don't mind me saying. Even though it's... wait a second. I guess it's more of a crypt? Inside of a crypt? I don't know. I mean, it's not a traditional coffin, it's more of a cube shape. But there's also something lying here. Mr. Deacon has something to give to us. Archdeacon set, which I am eager to read. White crown worn by an archdeacon of the Cathedral of the Deep, presented solely to delegates of the gods. Of the three archdeacons of the Deep, one cast off his white crown and left the cathedral to stand by Aldrich. Okay, so we we'll have to expect one of those guys again. Holy garb. Yeah, it's the same. Wait. Yeah, that's the same thing. Also got a deacon robe on my way here. Robe worn by deacons of the Cathedral of the Deep. The deep red pigment denotes the blessing of fire. In time, those dedicated to sealing away the horrors of the deep succumbed to their very power. It seems that neither tending to the flame nor the faith could save them. Okay, so these guys are actually tragic figures. I know, what else is new in Dark Souls, right? But, it seems they were, or at least their job used to be to keep the deep in check. Which, the deep and the abyss is probably the same thing. They refer to the same idea, but then, of course, the evil within it kind of, well, no relation to Capcom. it was too tempting, so they succumbed to it, and now they're the ones that are the prison. By the way, this guy on the bench, you can literally walk into him. He will not react. See? But we don't want to fight in here anyway. We do want to get these items too. Hopefully in this episode. But I think we need to do some other stuff first. Yeah. First of all. Wait. Is that the right way? Let's see. I hope so. yes, right. So, here's the thing. I tried to find a way over there. You know, along the path where we were so very rudely lowered down to a very, very angry giant. But whenever I tried to interact with the levers down there, that only interacted with the other two gates, or let's just say that gate and the one to the left of the one that I actually wanted to raise. So that was kind of weird. So there must be some other way to get across, because that was definitely the way I was supposed to go here. See that area over there? That's where I think some secret area is hidden away until we deal with the situation. So, we gotta find another way to gain admission. Come on, dude. Start your patrol. I guess we'll just run off then. Don't think it'll be able to follow us here. Although, I guess we'll see about that. He's going. Let's see if he can climb ladders. Doesn't look like it. Okay. So now I'm gonna go back to our bonfire and explore some other areas, because this whole place is quite intricate, and it's easy to leave some stuff behind. So we're gonna go through here first. That also gives me some time to talk about what we saw in the other playthrough. In the other character that I showed you. That was my third character that I made. She's a sorceress. A little sheepishly, I have to admit that I forgot her name. you gotta excuse me for that, but this is one of the areas that I didn't see at first. And we got an evangelist here, but what else? Yeah, that's true. Hey! And an item. Sweet. What's it gonna be? Want some fire as well? So my fire, ouch. Come to me. I'll give you some fire. No need to provide me with it. I got more than enough for myself. Oh, it did actually hit. I wasn't quite sure if it would. And there she goes. Quite easy to miss this little alcove. Deep gem. That's it? That's it, I guess. Okay. Fair enough. So here's the thing. I'm actually kind of glad about my fuck up in the video. Because had I talked to the... What the... Son of a bitch! God damn it! I did not expect that. You fucking slimes. Chase my fire! Okay, well then. Maybe that makes up for me not dying to the mimics all the time. But yeah, as I was saying, I think had I talked to the fake Zeke-ward before I went over this gate, I don't know how I would have reacted. If I had gone over and fallen into his trap, I'm not sure, but I would have been hesitant, to say the least. But now, I guess we have a different sort of quest line. So I'm also glad about that. We'll see how this goes. And now for this area. Remember how we... Well, first of all, it's quite easy to figure out that this room right here, this couldn't have been everything this room had to offer, right? And that gives you an idea that, hey, there could be a ladder over here. So you go up here and you fight the guy and you get the ring. But that's still not everything. So I found that out actually while I was still looking for a way to open up the area that I didn't have a lever for anymore. You can actually drop down from here. Looks a little bit risky, but it's actually not. And remember these bridges, or whatever you want to call them. Roof bridges. Jeff bridges. They look kind of tempting to jump to. When we ran... Oh, hello, my little friend. Or big friend, rather. Does not stagger easily, but he's very easily backstabbed. Oh! Sliver of health left. That's fine. So, I will be rolling all over the place here. Because this is kind of a secret area. I don't think... Oh my god. We have to go through this every time. Anyway. At least like this, I can show you the name of the character. Ayelet! That's what I called her. Anyway. You saw the other ones too there. So I completely forgot what we were talking about, but that's chest as well. Gonna have to be careful here. Who's hiding around every corner? But here we actually get to walk around on these girders that I believe is supposed to resemble like a rib cage, you know? Then there are the giants. Very gothic. That's one of the main features of Gothic Cathedral. Yes, it's not just a word you use for people who wear black makeup all the time. It's actually an artistic style that is very often used in architecture. Is there another guy behind me? Oh! There was a guy behind me, but only after I turned around. Okay. So, we'll take care of the other guy there too. Anybody else? I think it's fair that this kind of game makes you paranoid to a certain degree. But yeah, Gothic, I think when it comes to churches, that's my favorite architecture, although it's pretty grim and bleak. It's all about this memento mori they try to instill, because around the time this style was becoming popular. Where is that guy? I think it was a very affluent time. People were binging on all sorts of things and sinning and all that. And the Catholic Church back then was like... Oh, just an arbalist, huh? They were like, well, but don't you forget, memento mori, remember you are mortal. You will die someday, and then all the riches, all the indulgences you could be enjoying in your mortal life, or in your earthly life, I think they said, you won't have that anymore. Hail tongue. So therefore, you know, be good little children and follow the rule of the church, so you don't get the short end of the stick in the afterlife. Okay. I don't subscribe to that belief whatsoever, but I do like the style and the morbid nature of it. So there are... A few knights as well patrolling these parts. Okay, fair enough. As I was saying, we got this knight over here. Do not step onto this pixel. Patrolling the girders, so this must be something that's worth it. I hope. They always have a sliver of health left. Okay, what do you have for me here? Blessed gem, okay. Makes sense. And we got a cathedral knight armor. Very nice. Maybe we're gonna rock that next time. I'm kinda sick of that outfit. I don't know if you guys agree. But I would like to mix it up again. Just a little bit. So... I'm thinking... Fighting this guy over here is a little bit dangerous. So I'd rather do it... Ouch. I'd rather do it over here. Ouch, ouch. Can I push you off? Nah, I shouldn't try to be fancy here. Although, yeah! Oh, he didn't even die from that. Well, bye-bye anyway. Ouch. I can still kill you, you know. Don't think you got off easy. Nah, whatever. You're not worth it. Okay. So, this guy, and there's another one over there. Let's see if we can kite him. Because he has an arbalist. And I would rather not get shot. Yeah. Oh! He can hit me from here. Okay. Not from there, though. Okay. I guess you don't want to be kited. That's fair. I can just keep doing this and we're all gonna be happier for it. Because we're not gonna fall off these fucking girders again. Just give it some time. Nah. Gotta load the weapon at the exact... Well, not load it, but shoot it at the exact right time so that he doesn't duck below it. Almost done. Ooh, that was a critical. He's not dead yet. Oh, and he ducked below the final blow. There we go. Let's have some healing. Now, first of all, when I was here before, there was a message here. And yes, I know we are offline now, but it said illusion ahead. And it's also a little bit iffy. With the hitbox of the illusory, I mean the invisible wall. Okay. Guess it's not. That's fine. I thought it was here. Maybe it was on the other side. This way? No, that's just the exit. Now I still have to check them all. Whatever. Pretty sure it wasn't this side, but you never know. Whatever. Just so we don't have to go through here the next time, you know? Or whenever I do end up seeing other playthroughs and they find something that I didn't. I have to go back anyway. Better to do it now than later on. And always watch your feet. There's the evangelist. She's in a really bad spot, like it's kind of hard to fight her in that cramped spot there. It was actually easier to fight the other one at the beginning of this video. Okay, so last one we're gonna... Oh! We dropped something. Another knight armor. Okay, there's nothing here, but... Wait, what? I thought we can drop down here. No, we can drop down on the other one. There we go. That one I did see myself. There was no message there. I do try to not spoil myself, but I do read messages every once in a while. Because the game kind of... you know, I think the game is made and with you know, the message system in mind, so that you're supposed to be able to. You're supposed to be able to. Okay, is that? First of all, this is one of these slugs that we saw before. And here's Patches again. It's the guy that was responsible for our horrible death that one time. Hey, buddy.
Yes, hello. Oh, I don't believe we've met. I'm Patches. Unbreakable Patches. You seem to be unkindled. Do you have business with me?
Oh, fuck off. Should I or shouldn't I? I guess if I tell him, I don't think he's gonna attack me. But he'll think, you know, he'll try and make good with me. He'll try and make friends again if I say, I know who, you know who I am.
Oh, yes, of course. It's coming back to me now.
Oh my god.
Oh, I'm so sorry. That was my hand, as you know. But the deed, well, that was the armor's doing.
Oh yeah, sure, mate.
Truly. But behold, I'm stripped clean of that unruly attire. Look at you. Not a scratch. All's well that ends well, right?
What a fucking bitch.
I can tell. It's that rotten curse. It is. The untidy mess.
Prostration. Awesome.
Oh, yes. Now, it wasn't me, but you still deserve an apology. Just a little trinket. Go ahead. It's yours now.
A rusted fucking coin.
You should know, I'm a kind of traveling merchant. If you're as unkindled as you look, you'll find plenty of good stuff.
Yeah, that's the other reason why you'd maybe want to keep him alive, because he's proven to be a good merchant, because, you know, he does sell the stuff of the people he kills and pillages, which, you know, doesn't spell good things for old Siegward. He sells the black leather set too, and poison arrows, which is maybe very important, but we're not gonna buy from him just yet.
Can't find anything you like? Well, you could try looking a little harder.
Fuck off. Anyway, maybe this lever will make, that's another way over there. But first of all, let's see if this lever actually opens our path again. Like, where would it be? Here? No. Oh, over there, right. Okay, yeah, so that's our way back. And if we're, you know, we're not as stupid as, you know, falling for the same trick twice, so he's not gonna do that again. Hopefully. Uh-oh. Alright. Okay, I see where it goes. Ouch. Oh, he was gonna fucking spit his maggots at me again. Oh shit! Wait! I mean, cool it, guys! Maybe. Oh my god. Yeah, that's time for some pyromancy, I'd say. There we go. Look at them writhing. Fantastic. Wow. Yeah, you guys are pretty fucking disgusting, I must say. Somebody did a really good job designing you guys. But he's not shooting at us. Okay. Weird. I guess he's here for us to admire his magnificent model or something? I don't know. I'm always careful not to kill people who do not attack me. Also, on the way here, and also, you know, on the wall as well, just ignore that impaled maggot corpse. These things all the time on the walls and stuff. Sometimes it's like goo or I don't know, some sort of organic material. Sometimes it's these little roots everywhere. We saw those at the beginning as well. The first real boss, the quadriplegic, is that the word? Quadriplegic knight. We fought a vort of the Boreal Valley. The gate we opened to raise the banner also had, well, first of all, it was kind of deformed like this. It also had these little things on it. So who knows what's going on here? And who knows where this is leading? Okay. There is a bonfire over there. But be careful. There's items too. What the fuck? What is this? Hello? Oh my god. Welcome to your nightmares for the next few weeks or something. Rosaria, Mother of Rebirth. Okay, I see. I see now. Sure. We got Rosaria's fingers, Covenant. We're not, Okay. That's interesting. I was wondering where that game mechanic went. We can reallocate. Oh. Alright. Reallocating your attributes, and I guess you can also alter your appearance. Mother of Reba, okay, I get it. You used to be able to do that at the Firekeeper's place at the beginning of the game in Dark Souls 2, but you had to pay with an item that you could get. But apparently now they tie it to Pale Tongues, but I only have 3, and they need me to get 5 every time I want to. Reallocating my attributes basically means I can rearrange my stats on the character, which is cool, but I wonder, I guess there has to be some way of farming Pale Tongues in single player. Oh, okay. That's very telling as well. Remember our invader from before? Helm of Kirk, the notorious Knight of Thorns. A dense patch of thorns grows from its surface. A fitting item for the murderous Kirk, for even the simple act of rolling can damage enemies when wearing this attire. That's very interesting armor to have. Yeah, it's the same thing for everything. I told you that Kirk had a different reason for collecting humanity in Dark Souls 1, and maybe this has something to do with that. Like, Rosaria, has she something to do with the lady? What was her name again? Something lady. White lady? No. Fair lady. The fair lady. That's the one he was protecting, and he tried to make her life easier, so to speak. And all these cribs, that's just a You know there was a maggot in here sometime. And also, that's... First of all, she... If she had something to do with the fair lady, that's like a really grim fate for her. But it could also be the case that Kirk, after she died, just found a different person to serve, I guess. Also, I'm thinking maybe if I pledge myself to Rosario's fingers, this guy might talk to me or not. Maybe if I reload the game. Shouldn't take too long. So yeah, that's interesting. But also, all these cribs, the implication for that? What the f- Oh man. All the ragdolls just falling from the ceiling. Okay, so he never talks apparently, but I'm not gonna kill him for no reason, so whatever. And we will read up on Covenant items and the Covenants themselves when we found them all and when I'm ready to do some multiplayer. But we'll see when that happens. So now the last thing for me to do here is collect all the items down next to the giants. So you have that to look forward to. I will speed this up though, because I imagine I will die a bunch of times in the attempt. So don't worry about that. Here we go.
Oh, you're so cruel. You're teasing me with this gun. Alright, whose retina do I need to steal to get in there? I'm pretty sure whoever's in here is gonna have it. Big fucking gun development. Oh, do I need to shoot it with a railgun? Is that what this is? Is this a witness puzzle? Look for the smudges on the... What did I miss in this room? One of these panels has something on it. Is this one? Locked. Ah, that. Those are... Oh, what's this? Yes, test fire. Just shoot it through a wall. Who cares? Oh, he's that way. You have to, like, turn it around somehow.
Okay, so we got through all that. I didn't think I was gonna have to talk anymore in this episode, but apparently there's even more stuff we didn't find. Saint Biden. And we gotta look at the High Wall of Lothric again, and the Broken Bridge, and the Undead Settlement to keep things in perspective, and the big old tower over there as well. Homeward Bone. Okay. Is that the end then? It's usually what it means when you get a Homeward Bone. Anyway, so in that case, I get to read all this, these items I got. First of all, Drang Set. Where is it? Here. That looks fancy. Armor of the Drang Knights, proclaimed descendants from the land known for the legend of the linking of the fire. Fine protection that is both light and strong, having been reinforced with rare gay steel? The Drang Knights were once feared sellswords until treason meant descending into the abyss, and they were separated forever. Cool beans. Anything else here? No, that's the same thing. So, oops. Basically, where's my, things here. Basically, that means these guys are from Lordran, obviously. Cool. We also got the Maiden Set. White hood worn by traveling maidens, part of their formal attire, regardless of rank. It is soft and well made, but ill suited for use in battle. Does it say the same thing here? Yes. So, it didn't say exactly here, but this is the exact outfit that a character in Dark Souls 1 wore. Hey, did we? Oh, we didn't read these, did we? So the Deacons of the Deep. Yes, we did read it. After Aldrich left for the Boreal Valley. So even if you did miss Anri at the beginning of this episode, you would be able to glean from the soul that this is what you had to do. Go to the Boreal Valley. We also got a deep gem. A gem of infused titanite found in the dregs? Is it dregs? Of the Cathedral of the Deep, used an infusion to create deep weapons. Deep weapons inflict dark damage but lose scaling effects. There is a darkness that lies beyond human ken. Weird. Yeah, we read the small doll. Was there anything else? Oh yeah, the Bident and the Drang Hammers. Paired hammers of the Drang Knights, descendants from the land, blah blah. Same thing, but they have a spin bash. Bash foes with a large spinning motion and utilize momentum to transition into an overhanded strong attack smash. Good strength scaling. Just as good as the Executioner's Sword. Who knows? I quite like the Executioner's Sword. And the Bident. Let's see. Silver Bident, decorated by a holy symbol, formerly wielded by Saint Klimt. Gustav, first name? He discarded this weapon that draws upon one's faith on the day that he put his own faith behind him. Got a charge skill. Okay, I think that's about it. Next time, we're gonna explore beyond, what's it called? Beyond Farron Keep, I think. And see what lies there. Hopefully we get to experience the Boreal Valley as soon as we can. Until then, thank you for watching. And I'll see you next time.